Amazing Grace.
Three little ones. So she asked that we
our prayers, the Law's family.
Yeah. Bless your vision. Bless her. And remember this family. Bless her.
Like I said, it's good to see you. Thank God for the
blessing. Amen. Amen. Sure. Bless your heart, brother. It is. It's good to be saved.
Bless him.
Amen. It's good to have the Lord as my friend, my Savior.
Bless him.
It certainly is. I know I say this a lot, but besides him, there is another to that.
That's true. Amen.
There's nobody else that you can turn to or go to today to give you just exactly what you stand in need of. Because he can give it, Sean. Certainly.
He ain't your camper.
You need forgiveness, why he can do that. You need salvation, why he'll give that. I'm glad he'll be a mother, he'll be a father, he'll be a friend, he'll be a sister, he'll be a brother.
Amen. He'll be all you need, amen.
So I'm glad tonight that I know him. Amen. Hopefully we've come looking for a good time. The Lord's house, Michael singing that song about amazing grace. Couldn't help but think how amazing it really is tonight. Because it really is. It's through his grace, amen, that we're here tonight.
Amen. Amen.
It's through his grace that I was saved through faith. Amen. Not of myself, but it's a gift and that of God. And I believe that's about word for word. Amen. This evening, so tonight, it's through his mercy and his grace tonight that we've met out here tonight. And you know what? I'd like for somebody to meet that grace and find it.
Amen.
Find that grace that I did many years ago. I really would tonight. And I know it's his will to save those that are lost tonight. It certainly is. Amen. So it's a good place for me to be tonight.
Amen.
I'm just looking for him to come through in a mighty way. Amen. And bless his people. Amen. Jeremy.
Ray Kennedy was down in the garage today, and you know, I talked to him there for a minute. He was talking about, you know, I was asking about his health and stuff. He said that he's just getting old now. You know, I think he said he's getting ready to turn 80. And, you know, he said he's been preaching since he was 20 years old, and I couldn't help but think. How many lives that
have been saved? Come on, Jeremy. Yeah.
You know, in his ministry.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
I know the Lord's here because I brought him with me. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Every one of us has something to be thankful for.
Amen.
We stand too quiet a lot of times on the Lord.
Yeah,
don't worry, I was sitting there walking on, I was thinking, I was reading about the sower, went out and sowed, you know. They said some went on stony ground, some went on good ground.
Sure enough.
What ground are you on tonight?
Yeah.
Are you the one that's going to stand by and wither away? Are you going to be stand fast in the Lord? You're going to be rooted in the ground in what the Lord's got you to do.
Bless him more.
I'm so thankful. I know when I was 8 years old, I got rooted in the right thing.
Yeah.
You know, so many people want to say, they come in and out of the church, and they spring up, and then you see them, they wither away. They ain't there no more. They're gone, but you know, you got to be rooted in the ground. If you want to see the lost saved, we've got to be rooted in the ground in the Word. We've got to be rooted in the ground in what's right. You know, so many times I've been there that I've been in the ground where sometimes when I was younger that I withered away for a little while. But you know, I got back to where I need to be at.
Yes.
And I thank God that I am.
Bless him more.
I thank God that I know I'm rooted in the ground and in the right thing.
Amen.
And I thank God for a church that's rooted in the ground and the right thing.
Amen.
You look around, there's too many churches anymore that's withered away. They even got, a lot of them ain't even got the mortars bitch on anymore. It's all a program. It's all it is a program. You know, I thank God if they ever bring a program in here, I'm going, Mark. And I thank God it's not that way here. I thank God that I know I'm a child of God.
Amen. God bless you, Sean.
My best of churches doing them, my two youngest brothers, and there's others I'd like to remember. These that are Christians that are doing things in front of people that they shouldn't be doing.
Right.
It's leading them astray.
Sure.
My best of church members, they just lost that desire and they don't care anymore.
Bless your past.
Amen.
Amen.
thank you, Lord, for saving an old sinner like me. That's what I was. I'm just an old sinner. I don't understand it. It's just love, mercy, and grace.
Bless
I can't explain it any other way, or I'd still be bouncing around out here lost. She'd probably be at church, and I'd be sitting at the house watching something on TV.
God bless you, Pop.
But I'm thankful to have found this church. I'm thankful for my church family.
Yeah.
I can't stand here today and watch me pray too. Come on, Paul. Bless you, brother. I'm loving y'all so much.
Bless you.
I love my church. I'm just thankful that the one lady too.
Yeah.
Bless you.
I just couldn't thank the Lord enough, not for what He truly suffered for me. Not less than unbearable. But thanks be to the Lamb of God that I have got stronger this week. I thank the Lord for all that He blessed.
Amen. Amen. God bless your heart.
Disagreements every day when he starts talking about that stuff, and I talk about, you know, I said, I don't believe it that way. And they may have the same salvation that I got, but it's just it's not my beliefs, you know. You got to do this, you got to do that. That's not the way the Lord meant it to be.
No, amen.
Amen. Charity will never fail.
Amen.
I'm glad tonight for the love that He's shown to this world.
Amen.
That whosoever will let them drink.
Amen, brother. Come on.
Of life freely.
Yes, amen.
So this evening, I'm glad tonight to be part of that love and that mercy. Glad that I can stand here before you and say I'm glad tonight of my church family, the place that I long to be.
Yes, amen.
Amen. Where I feel at home.
Yeah.
Amen. I certainly do tonight. So, amen. It's a wonderful place to be.
Yes.
Y'all
were
taking some too. I'm going to help God works.
Yes.
I prayed, and people when they just scream, I prayed for years and years that me and Marty, sometime or another, we could be in church somewhere together. And then little did I know that he's going to become my pastor. And I want you to know, Marty, buddy, I love you. You don't know how much you mean to me. You don't know what all you helped me through. I mean, just knowing that you're my friend. I thank God for you. I thank God for Marlon. I thank God for your family. And I want you to know how much I love you. I want everybody in this church to know how much I love you. Because, you know, before I came here, I got to the point that I just thought, well, this is another church service.
Yeah.
You know, I ain't saying against no church, but you know, when I was over to Alders and over there, I was getting to the point there right after God called me preaching, well, it's just another church service. It's another church service. And then good little did I know God was going to lead me over its way. And I remember it was one Valentine's Day morning. Kitty was sick, and I was coming over here to church to visit with Mom and him. I got about over with it in the desert park, and the word God told me, He said, you're going to join us this morning. I thought to myself, Lord, no, I ain't either. I said, I'm just going to order peace. I was going to turn and go back home. God told me, if you turn that truck around, you'll never make it back home. You know, and that's how much I fear God, because I come on over here and I join this church. It's the best thing I've ever done. And I believe it's the best thing in my Christian life I've ever done. I've grown more in this church than I ever have anywhere I've been. But you know, like I said, little did I know that later on, after I join it, Marty's going to be my pastor. And I want you to know, Marty, how much I really appreciate you, buddy. I thank God for this church and how much I appreciate this church and what it means to me.
Amen, boy.
just something about this place that's different than any place I've ever been in my life. God, this is a special place that God set up here on the side of the road here. And I thank God today. I'm glad to be a member of it. I like Marty. A lot of times, the closer I go here, the more I'm pushed to hell. Because and a lot of times, the people, let's go. Let's go. We're going to be way too early. You know, I can't help it. I just thank God for this place and what it means to me.
My boss, her husband, pastors up at Good Hope now, and me and her always talk about our services, and there was a member that came in, and another girl was waiting on him, and he came over and started talking to me, and he said, I've been in a service like that one time, and he said, it was at my sister's funeral, and he said, the little preacher that was preaching, he said, went back to my nephew and said he started talking to him, and he shook his hand, and he said he was preaching on the rest, and he said that little did I know that night that my great nephew was going to get killed, and I asked him, I said, what was your sister's name? And he said, Patricia Witt, and I said, well, that little preacher you're talking about, that's my pastor. And he said, well, praise the Lord. He said, I'll never forget that message. And he said, I'd like to come visit that church sometime. I told him, you know, you just come on any time. And he said, that's just stuck with me. And it's been going on a year, I guess. And he said, that's just stuck with me for about a year. So, you know, it goes out in people, you know, our little church is on people's minds. Then I told him, I said, that's my husband, too. He said, well, praise the Lord, you know. And, but he said, you know, that little boy, you know, he said he had a harder time getting over him than he did his sister. He said, but that message that he preached that day, he said, about arrest, he said, that's stuck with me for almost a year now. And remember that man. I'm not sure if he even goes to church anywhere or not, but remember him. And I hope I say this right. Forgive me if I say it wrong. But I was studying about the Philistines and how they had all these gods and they wanted all these gods, and that they had the more gods they had, the more they felt better, they felt safer. And they eventually won and got the Ark of the Covenant for a short period of time.
Come on, Brittany.
And they had it, and I was reading on that and seeing what that was and where the Ten Commandments and stuff was in it.
Yep.
And it was so powerful.
Oh,
and
yeah.
They got it, and it wasn't working for them because they
right.
wasn't the God that they but they were serving, and they had to take it back because it was more powerful than what they had. And I just kept thinking about the one God that I got when I got saved. That was the only
Brittany.
One I needed. It was a powerful one. But I kept thinking about what Sean said about the seeds and going away, and you know, if they was really rooted and grounded, and they wouldn't go away. If they got the one true God they needed, they wouldn't
yes,
go away.
That's right.
The Bible says even if they go away, if it was trained up right, that they would come back. If they got the right God, they would
yeah.
come back.
Yeah.
I'm thankful for the God that I got. I don't need to keep searching and keep trying to get all these different gods. I
yeah.
only got, I got the one that I need.
Amen.
Amen.
God bless your heart.
Sunday, but it feels like it's
yeah.
forever.
That
I thank God for what he showed you when you're not even in church. I got up Sunday morning, was looking out at the ocean, and got to thinking about those waves.
Every time.
And his church showed me how those waves are blessings, and that sometimes it happens, they're just a little bitty, and they don't come in, but sometimes they're so busy, they about knock you over. And but to get those blessings, you had to get out there in that ocean. And the thing was, and that the Lord showed me was, the waves just kept coming. Yeah. Just like the blessings of God, they just keep coming. They never stop. And that, as long as we're out there, and we can receive those blessings. And I'm glad tonight to know that I'm out there. And I can feel those blessings every once in a while. And me and the kids, man, standing there. I ride the ocean, man, and I started singing the songs that we sang around here. And just about that church right there in the middle of the ocean. And I thank God for that. I thank God no matter where we're at, He's there. He don't have to be in these walls. I thank God for this church, and I thank God for each and every one of you. But I'm glad He's not just confined in this building. But He can go wherever we're at. And when I thank God that He saved me. And like Sean said, I'm glad He sent me this way and let me be a member of this church. But I'm thankful for what He shows me. And if you want a blessing tonight, just step out there in it. It may be a little blessing, and it'll come in, but it might be a big one, and it'll overtake you, and knock you down. I thank God for those big blessings, but I thank you for those little ones, too. You know, we can't go thank God for this. Bob in here tonight, he always says, and I pray for everything. And I kept looking at the weather, and every day he said it was going to rain the whole time we were there. And I said, Lord, if it be in your will, just let us have good weather. Just let us have good weather. It could be in your will. And it rained for about 30 minutes the whole time we were there. That's all it rained. But I thank God for that answered prayers. Even when it's so simple as just saying, let's have good weather, He can answer our prayers. We have to ask. And that's what we don't do so many times, is we don't ask. We just sit around and say, well, I wish this would happen, or I wish that would happen. If you ask God and truly mean it, He'll bless you, man. If it's just the little things. And I thank God for the little waves and those big ones. And thank God for what He shows me.
Come in here, you know, the outside might be calm, but boy, it's like like you said the one night, I ain't forgot. You know, the waves just stirred up on the inside every single time I come here. And I'm thankful for that, you know. If I didn't have that, I know I'd have to get down on this altar. You know, I'm thankful to have that stirring up on the inside. So I'm thankful to know that he saved me.
Amen, brother.
Every time we pass another car, we're within inches of death.
Yeah.
That's how many times he spares us his mercy and grace every day.
Amen.
And then I tried to count the number of breaths that I took, and I couldn't. But all those were also by his mercy and grace.
Yes. Amen.
And I just want to thank him. There's nothing more that I can do. He's everything.
Yes, he really is.
Nothing else matters.
That's right.
Not one thing.
Amen. Bless her, Father.
And while Jonathan was talking, I was thinking, his word is the truth. Uh-huh. And all men are liars.
Yes, amen. We all
are. His word promises that it will serve him.
God bless the Lord.
It's your fault.
what y'all needed. And so very much, y'all been nothing but a blessing. Thank you, Lord. When I think about my prayers, I believe with all my heart y'all pray. For me and my family, it makes me ashamed of myself.
Bless you, Lord.
And that, do I pray for you all? I'm not gonna lie, yes. But I can always do that much better.
Yeah, we are.
I just thank the Lord for all that you've blessed.
Now you got a testimony on your heart. And the Lord.
I was thinking about Bob. He was stoned about a year ago. We went to the hospital on Tuesday to see the little babies. Eric met us out there.
Come on, Randy.
He turned around and looked at me and he said, "You know a preacher named Oliver Wolf and Martin?" I said, "Oh." I said, "He brings your Bible about a week before I got saved." And he said, "That's his niece right there. She was a nurse." And he called her in there later, you know. And she was telling me about it, you know. And I said, "Well," I said, "How old is he?" And she said, "Well, he's about 86. And I said, "Well, about 35 years ago, he preached your Bible. I got saved a week later." I just want to tell Bob, 35 years from now, I feel my precious. If you still remember, you know, and I just thank the Lord he lets me go back when I got saved, you know. I wasn't thinking about that going down there. I just was going to see that baby, you know. I wasn't thinking about nothing. When it came, you know, I got to go back to where I got saved. I appreciate that.
God bless you, Randy. Thank you, Lord. Oh, it may have been a while since you told you one. You need to tell it tonight. Amen. Tell it.
Thank you, Lord. Thank God I'm saved. Don't ever get tired and give up on praying for somebody. I prayed for years for my dad. He always made fun of me and Sharon for going to church. He wanted to go to Baptist on Sunday. And I thought he was going to go on Saturday, but he wouldn't go on Saturday. He wouldn't go on Sunday. Well, I wouldn't go with him.
Yeah.
Well, he got diagnosed with type B hepatitis and damaged his liver. Still lost. Still praying. But God to heal him, to save him. I worked two jobs at the time, and one out about 10 o'clock, I got a phone call, and I got saved. It was 6 weeks before he died.
Wow.
I just thank God he was saved before he got there.
Right.
And if you'd asked me 5, 6, 7 years ago, and I'd been in church with Barney Banner and John Angel, I thought it was crazy. But I thank God for it.
Yeah. Bless you. Amen.
Amen.
Bless you, Gary. God bless your heart.
Of your life.
out those pews. We don't know.